All right, here's this. This is a CRA Pro Late model. This is a class that it runs. It's a template body deal. It's got a GM 604 crate engine in it, obviously carbureted kind of thing. I don't really know much about the rules for the engine itself. I know that being a crate engine, they do that just to try to get the class close power wise. And this particular engine, as of last year, was required to run a inch 200 restrictor under the carburetor. So they're trying to balance the class power-wise very well. So any advantages you can get are going to come from stuff you can change, like running different oils, air cleaner design stuff, as far as like air pan, where you're pulling the air source from, the carburetor itself. That kind of thing. So this is just a pump gas engine. I believe it's like a 9.5-10 to 1 deal, which would make sense for the compression ratio, but I believe that's just what the class requires. So this will be something interesting. This is actually here to get broken in. It is a fresh engine. We're gonna do some braking procedure stuff, which is just a lot of moderate load, slow RPM sweeps to basically trying to vary manifold vacuum to set the ring. So we're going to go through that process first and then start tuning it. I have two carburetors to set up for this. I'll be curious to see if there's an advantage one over the other. Sometimes there is, sometimes there's not. It depends. So one of them is a brand new carb. The one that's on it was on their last engine. So I'm going to get this thing strapped down, run through the break-in process, and then we'll start going through the tuning process. I know right now he's got this thing set at 35 degrees of timing. I think once I get through the break-in process, get it up to temperature, I'm gonna drop that down to 30 and we'll start at 30, get the feeling close and start bumping a couple degrees into it until we see the torque peak level off. So yeah, I'm gonna drive it into this thing and get the engine broken and we'll go from there. Okay, so that was the first hit. The wideband reading was so rich that it actually didn't even get a good reading, so it was mid-10s all the way. I'm going to go ahead and move some jet sizes. I don't know what's in this yet, but we're going to probably pull 4 sizes out of it to start and then go from there. So, going to keep working. All right, here's the power curve. All the dots are because we didn't make it through the recording window, so it recorded on the way up and on the way down. You see the little torque hit here in the center. This thing's got a lot of gear in it. It's got like a 567 gear in it currently. I was starting the pull at 3000. I'm probably going to try it at 2500 and see if that'll smooth that value out there. But you can see these dips here and here. That's actually where it was breaking up because of how much fuel was in it. So now that we've got the 70 jets in it, that's not true because we've got 70s in the front and 72s in the back. So we've gone down 2 sizes in the front, 3 sizes in the back, and we'll see if that fixes our overly rich issue. It made Right there, 326 horsepower, 364 foot-pounds of torque. It made peak power at 5,800. Again, this thing is a little, it's got 30 degrees of timing in it. They typically, from what I've, what the customer told me, they usually run around 35. So that power peak will move as we increase timing, and I will show you that as well. But for now, we're ready to get some fuel back in the carburetor and make another hit with the jet change. Okay, you can definitely tell it ran smoother that time all the way to the limiter. This class runs a 6400 chip. It's still in it. I've left it there. So it didn't make a big peak number difference. I'll show you. It made 327 peak rather than 325. It actually lost a little bit of torque, but again, because of that hit in the beginning. It still has that spike in the initial throttle pickup. It's kind of the dilemma with the dyno with light rollers like this thing has and the gear ratio the car has. If this thing had a 410 in it rather than the 567 gear that's in it, that would be much more controllable. It's just kind of violent the way it sits. But check out the average number difference. Whoops, sorry. Was on the top there, 250, 231. So 19 foot-pounds of torque and like 8 horsepower. Look at the difference in the curve. I'll move that out of your way a second. So yeah, check out the difference in the curve. The top line obviously being the one with the fuel pulled out of it, the bottom line being without it. So see how much of a difference it made up here. Where it was breaking up before, it didn't run clean. Obviously it ran clean through that time, looks much better. So now that the jetting's in the ballpark, ignition timing will have an effect on the AFR. So I'm gonna start putting a couple degrees of timing in it and see how it likes it. See how it likes the timing change. See what it does to the fuel curve. It is mid 11s now, which is still pretty rich. I'm gonna leave the thing a touch safe. I want to leave it around probably like low 12s because these things travel all over the country, different elevations, different humidity, way different weather conditions. Excuse me, so I tend to tune them a little conservative on the fuel so they've got some, it'll move around a little bit and still be okay. Timing wise, it's pretty much the humidity will have an effect on it, but again, margin for error on something like this is pretty decent, so we'll leave the timing a little bit conservative, say 2 degrees shy of MBT, and run it there. So I'm gonna put 2 degrees in this thing, leave the jetting alone, and we'll make another hit and see what happens. Okay, we put 2 degrees in it, so it's got 32 total in it. It saw some pretty good gains. Looking like went from, well, here's the before and after. So 358 to 363, 327 to 336. So decent on the peaks, but the average is really where it's at. Check out the horsepower average difference, 184, 203. You can see the graphs here, how much it just improved it. Pretty much everywhere. So we're gonna put 2 more degrees in it, knock the thing up to 34, make another hit and see where that gets us. Okay, 34 degrees in it. AFR is now into the 12.0 area, and we picked up another 9 foot-pounds of torque and 11 horsepower. So that's at 34, so we're gonna put 2 more in it and see how it likes it. I'm gonna guess we're gonna end up around 36, 38 maybe even. But you can see how much of a difference that made. Everywhere from about 4,000 on. So, which is really where these things are going to operate anyway, but
But yeah, looking good. I'm gonna put two more in it and give her another go. Okay, so here's the graph with 36 degrees in it. AFR is now 11.9 in the beginning, 12.2 at the end of the hit. So it's right about where we want it. A little conservative, which is what I'm shooting for with this thing, right? So you can see with the 36 in it, there's some deviations where it made more, a little bit here, a little bit there, same here, same there. So on 34 degrees, it made peak power out here, and on 36, it moved the power peak back 200 RPM. That and the slight deviations through the curve tell me that we're pretty much at MBT or very close to it. I'm going to leave the thing at 36 degrees and call it good. It does need to be, again, a little bit conservative. It also is geared really short, so it'd be cool to put like a 410 gear ratio in this thing and see what it would want for timing. Then I would expect it to be in the 34, 32 range with the gear change. But without doing it, we don't really know. So gonna call this one good. I do have another carburetor to put on here and dial in, so we'll see if that makes any difference, and I'm gonna get moving on that. All right, after the carburetor change, we lost a little bit of power. The AFR was like 12.15, 12.10 instead of the 12.25. So, you know, close enough to be, you know, whether that makes a difference or not, I would argue that it doesn't. And the other carburetor made a little bit more horsepower for whichever reason. I ran them at the same oil temp, same coolant temp, that whole thing. So give you an idea here for peak numbers. So the original carburetor made 353 or 352.9, and the new one made 345.6, and then torque was pretty close. So that's a wrap for this thing. So as it turns out, I was lying. That wasn't the last hit. I got a text from this customer in the morning, and they asked me to pull the restrictors out because, as I said previously, this is this engine runs a restrictor. So the restrictor was worth the difference there, so like 23 horsepower. But here's the curve difference. Pretty big change average over the duration. So yeah, ended up making 368 to the tire with the restrictor pulled out of it. So yeah, I thought that was interesting. Again, it's a CRA Pro Late model, so it is a sealed GM 604 crate engine class. And this engine is required to run a restrictor because they were outperforming the rest of them previously. So to try to keep the field even, they put that restrictor in there, and that's what it killed, about 23 horsepower. So kind of interesting. But so again, that's it for this one for sure this time, because they're on their way to come pick it up. Thanks for watching.